What's up, everybody? This is Christina, and you are watching Singled Out Saturday. Today, we are going to be discussing the role and responsibility of your happiness. So, oftentimes, people get into relationships because they're lonely. They want somebody to make them happy. They want the Hallmark scene. They want the Lifetime movie without the drama. And that is just not reality. It's not really fair to get into a relationship and expect someone else to fulfill your happiness. That is too much for anybody to carry. That is too much of a burden. And the big question is, if you don't know what makes you happy, how are they supposed to know what makes you happy? If you are expecting someone to come in and serve the purpose of being your sole provider for happiness, what happens when they fail? What happens when they're not having a good day and they can't provide you the happiness that you're looking for? What happens when circumstances come in and your attitude is switched? What happens when they fail at providing you with happiness? The issue is, it's not their responsibility. It's yours. How do you discover what makes you happy? The single season. That is the time you explore, you find out who you are, you find out what you like, what you don't like, what makes you happy. Me, for example, in this single season, I found out that books, wine, chocolate, and a good romantic comedy makes me happy. Those are things that make me smile. Those are things that make me feel good. Not just those, but I found out certain things about myself. I found out that, hey, I need to take a break. I need to have some rest. I need to have some time where I can refuel, because if I'm not refueled, I'm going to be angry. I'm going to be snippy. I'm going to be aggravated. But it's not your partner's job to figure out what makes you happy. It is their job to complement your happiness. It is your job. It is their job to come in and to the relationship should be a bonus. It should be something that it benefits. You guys benefit from each other's happiness. You're happy, he's happy. He happy, you happy. It is a thing where you come together, two happy people come together and they have added happiness. When you come together and you are broken, you are emotional, you are dealing with past trauma, you are dealing with identity crisis, you are dealing with not knowing what you want, you are dealing not knowing what you're worth, when you're dealing with not knowing whose you are, you cannot come and authentically be happy and merge with someone who is happy, because you're not going to align. And then you're going to leave heartbroken. You're going to end up breaking his heart. He's going to end up breaking your heart. And we're going to have two damaged people that's going out and creating a big fest of just anger and just not goodness. So your job is to discover what makes you happy. Sit down, journal. If you don't journal, vlog. If you don't vlog, read and figure out what makes you happy. Figure out what your requirements are. Figure out what you need. It is okay to need something. You're not being needy if you state what you need. If you need security, state that. If you need positive vibes, state that. If you need little drama, state that. If you, for example, I require stability and I need to feel protected. I need to feel like I can, like you are protecting my heart. You are protecting me. You are protecting us. If I do not feel protected, I'm out. It's a no for me. That is a non-negotiable. Feeling protected is what makes me happy. Having stability is what makes me happy. You have to figure out what it is that you need, what it is that you require from the other person, but you have to know what makes you happy, and you have to be able to fulfill your own happiness. If you have no idea who you are, you won't know how to be happy. If you have no idea whose you are, you won't be happy. It is a vicious cycle the dating world, they always say the dating world in your 30s is, it looks like a cesspool. You know why it looks like a cesspool? Because nobody did the work in the single season. They got into relationships, they got damaged, and then they entered the dating world again without going through the process of healing, without going through the process to figure out what they want, who they want, and how they want things. It is okay to have a plan. You need to plan. If you want to be in a relationship, you need to plan to be in a relationship. You need to be whole to be in a relationship. You need to be healed and you need to be happy. They are not going to make you happy if you yourself are not already happy. Your happiness is your responsibility. It is no one else's. It is not their job to make you happy. That is your job. Happiness is a choice. So wake up, decide to be happy, and decide to figure out what makes you happy. And I promise you, the seeds that you are sowing into your single season are going to reap a bountiful, a happy courting, relationship, engagement, marriage season. But you have to do the work. If you hide and you cower down and you do not do the work, you cannot reap what you have not sown. That's just the law. You sow a seed, you get a plant. You sow good things into your single season, which are your healing, your happiness, your discovery phase. You sow into that, you are going to reap a bountiful, plentiful relationship. But you have to do the work. Stop expecting other people to make you happy. Stop expecting things to make you happy. Get to the core. Work and make sure you play a part in your own rescue. Go to counseling. Write. Do something. But don't sit and be stuck and then damage the person that's coming along and falling for the facade that you're putting on. Heal. Be whole. Be happy. Peace.